Hey guys, I am back with the first of hopefully many of my redo type reviews. Today, as you can tell, I'll be doing Power Rangers. These are the Zords from Season 1, unless I'm hardly mistaken. I will be covering the Megazord, Dragonzord, Titanus, who has a very interesting name, if you can actually separate it and say it differently. So starting off, I will do the Dinozords. Here we have the Dinozords, broken up in their separate components. In order, here we have the Mastodon. Nice looking, and there's very little articulation for each of these guys in their separate modes. His is pretty much limited to his trunk can move up and down. Apparently about it. When you're buying these guys, mainly him, make sure he has the trunk, make sure he has the tusks. Mine are glued in because I don't want to lose them. And make sure that the tusks still are very chromey. The chrome helps. The only thing you really do with this guy is pretend that he can get himself on his hind legs and do this kind of action. Besides that, his articulation is nil. There is nothing. That's all he does. He just sits there. So, beside, here we have the Pterodactyl. Pretty nice. These guys are all very basic. This is from 91, I believe. Very basic. The head can move up and down on the neck. There's a little joint at the top, so it can do this kind of action. And you can't pretend that the wings can flap if you really, really, really try hard enough. Not bad. Pretty cool. Here are the Triceratops. This guy has wheels on the bottom, so he rolls around very nicely. He has some pretty nice little tank treads on around here. The head, again, moves up and down if you really pretend. The tail, you can spring forward kind of and do this little cannon action if you really, really want to. But again, not a whole lot of articulation. Stickers look really nice. When you're getting him, make sure his horns are attached. The horns are important. Without the horns, he's nothing. Next, we have the Sabertooth Tiger. I think this one is kind of my favorite from these Zords because it actually does stuff. You can move the legs in a variety of ways. I love those joints. The head can move up and down. You can rotate the tusks around if you really want to, or the fangs. Not tusks, they're fangs. And, the lat leg moves. And the tail, you can kind of do a little gun action here also. This one has kind of the most play value out of all these, I do believe. Pretty cool. Last but not least is the Tyrannosaurus. This guy, I think, was everybody's favorite from the Rangers in this set. Maybe unless you were a girl, then you kind of went on with the females, but Tyrannosaurus is definitely pretty cool. Mouth does open pretty wide. He's got a jawbreaker in his mouth, as you can tell. There's a nice big jawbreaker that he can never eat. And you can tilt his head up if you really want to. Does not rotate. The arms have very little gimpy movements. He's a T-Rex, so he doesn't really have a whole lot of arm movements. Yeah, that's all he does there. My one kind of complaint, though, is that to have his tail locked in, you have to have him in this pose. Like this. He looks a whole lot better if you disconnect the tail, bend his feet a little further down, and then do kind of like this. He looks better, but with his tail being unhooked, he's a lot more back heavy. He kind of just kind of falls over a little bit. So, he looks better. Add a frame in, Shiho. He looks better when he's upright like this, but you kind of take away his stability, so it just kind of be weary of that. Now, these guys were the original Zords. They formed the original Megazord. I think the original is my favorite out of all of them. It's one of the ones I actually grew up with. But I think it's the most iconic from all the Power Rangers. To make this, they would form into the Megazord tank mode. Unless they would skip that entirely. To form the tank mode, let's see if they actually stand. Take Sabertooth Tiger. Fold the little fangs up like this. They just rest like that. Fold the feet flat. Fold those in, fold the tail forward, got that. This guy, look, ready? Don't blink or you will miss his transformation. That's it, that's all you do. Next, take Mr. Tyrannosaurus Rex. Gonna fold his legs forward and fold them back so his knees are in the front. And slide them in, where you are, there you are, like that. repeat, just like this. And he's ready to roll. Quite literally. He now has wheels. He can roll around. Very nice. Very, very stupendous. Now go around to his back section. Take off the head to the mammoth. Set it aside. Undo all of this. This is just going to become exposed. If you want, you can spring these forward. I think in the show, they would actually kind of fit on like this. There's not really a whole lot. There's these little clips here that kind of hold it to his back, but these little sections are going to tab into his sides, and this will be the arms for the Megazord later on. So just get it on here. It doesn't really clip per se, but the sides, lock them around, they clip in place. And there's that. Now the tail, you can leave it, you know, like this if you want. It kind of tabs in like this, and I feel a sneeze coming on. Okay. You can leave it like this if you want to, but do the full tank mode. You have to kind of just let it kind of hang here like this. We'll get there later. Next, there are these two little cannons. Now, I do not know a place where you can store these when they're all separated. So they just kind of sit there. But these little cannons are going to tap into the fronts of what were the mammoth's feet. And these become the cannons like this. Next, take the mammoth head. Extend this little tab in the back. And that's going to fit right into there. I got a text. It's going to fit like that. Last but not least, turn around. Take the pterodactyl. Now, I have seen pictures that have different poses for this. Some of them have the pterodactyl like this with the wings extended. The official kind of, like, I don't want to say CGI, but the original workup art I saw had the wings folded in and the head forward like this. I'm going to go with this one. There are two little tabs right here that are spring-loaded, and they kind of just rest into the feet of the mammoth in the back, kind of like this. And let me turn this light on, see if that'll actually help a little bit. But here you have the Megazord in its tank mode. Definitely kind of fierce looking. It's a little scary. I'm gonna have nightmares from this now. Definitely looks pretty cool. You know, I like that it can actually roll around. Except for the back dragon, so you have to kind of lift up the back. Maybe that's why the tail's here, so you can have a little grip. And rolls pretty nice. The cannons can move pretty much in a variety of directions. These joints are a little loose, so they kind of flop around. You can do all this kind of stuff. I believe in the show, each of the heads of the Zords would fire its own separate laser. Just kind of a stretch. But that's how it would look, and it's kind of cool. And there are times when I was going to Megazord, it would skip this mode entirely for reasons that we really don't know. But to get to its Megazord mode, separate the pterodactyl, go ahead and fold the head in like this, just to get it ready. Pull off the mammoth head, set it aside, take off these two little cannons, and they're going to fit into the back just like this. And while you're back here, fold up the tail. Now, let's see if I can do this right. I did this right the first time. But what would happen is it would rise up kind of like this and rest like this, and a cannon fell off. These cannons will fall off quite a bit, and I realize you cannot see this, so give me one little second. And he would rise like this, and then the feet would fold away inside. He would fold the feet in, and then put the arms down. Fold these up so the M is facing in its proper direction. And then all that's left is to take this chest piece, fold it down, and this I always thought was kind of cool in the show. Head one folds in, that folds up, pterodactyl flies in, locks in place with a few little well-placed tabs, and then you extend the sides of the Megazord head, and there you go. This is, in my opinion, the only true Megazord. I like this guy. I like how he looks. This is made in about 91, so there is very, very little articulation. I think Megazords to this day still have very small bits of articulation. They don't have a whole lot. It's okay. We can look past that. They are combiners. In terms of articulation, what does he have? Well, the arms can move a full 360. There is very little elbow movement here. You can really pretend. The head has no movements. The legs, kind of. You can bend the legs outward like this. You can do that. The problem is there are no knee joints. So, obviously you cannot stand him like this. That would just be ridiculous. But the legs do have a little bit of movement. Not a whole lot. He's pretty much a brick for the most part, but it's the kind of brick you like. Next. Now, this is kind of funny. When they would turn into Megazord, the Mammoth head would pull an Optimus Prime, pretty much. Body would remain, the head would vanish. We don't know where it would go. Much like Prime's trailer. We don't know where it would go. But then suddenly it would randomly appear in the hand of the Megazord as a shield. Ta-da! And I think they only really used the shield a few times in the show. It wasn't like one of those common things. What was common, though, was the Power Sword. They would do a whole praise, you know, let's bring in the Power Sword, do a prayer, do a little chant while naked. Power Sword would swoop into the ground, they'd pull it, and there you go. This guy looks pretty cool, I like him. The sword, nice and chromed out. Mine has actually been under somewhere. It is fairly old, but sword looks pretty cool. It's a nice, iconic type look. And really, you know, this is the Megazord. I love this guy. One thing to note is that Ripper Labels has sets for Power Ranger stuff now. They have Megazords, the Dragazord, and Titanus. These stickers are not show accurate. They are kind of like a weird version of it. And you see a lot more with the Dragonzord. He has a lot more like lightning bolts instead of the standard stickers that they would have. So you may want to just buy this guy, take off all the stickers, and just buy a fresh set from Repro Labels. They look a whole lot better. I do plan to buy some, but they are kind of pricey because you're getting so much. But there is that. So, put him aside. Next, we have, because five Zords aren't enough, the Dragonzord. Dragonzord is actually kind of a rip from Godzilla, pretty much. When he would rise out of the water, out of the harbor, he would do this whole classic Godzilla rise to the water, shake around kind of pose, destroy the city. And when he fires missiles from his fingers, well, he has little cannons, which you can kind of see. It's pretty much a direct rip from Mechagodzilla. He would fire little missiles from his fingers, too. He still looks cool, though. I mean, the Green Ranger was a lot of kids' favorites. He was my favorite Ranger. Started off a bad guy, became a good guy, and then came back later on as the leader type thing. So it's kind of like, you know. This guy, articulation-wise, legs have... And you can say he has knees if you really... I mean, you're kind of stretching it because you're kind of disconnecting from his entire body, but you can pretend and say that he has knees if you really freaking want to. I don't know why you would, but hey, it's there. The tail has a little bit of movement on the tip. It is on its own little separate joint. You can do this kind of stuff. Arms, they move up, they move down. The wrists are turn, not a whole lot. You know, it's kind of eh. And the mouth does a little chompy-chompy action. What is kind of cool, this guy has electronics. Gonna turn this light off real quick. There we go. There's a little red switch on his back. All you gotta do is slide the switch forward and we get... And that's what happened when he would fire his little rocket doolallies. I mean, it's a very basic little sound and... But, you know, it's there. He showed that they tried a little bit. Get my light back on here. Now, this wasn't enough. We couldn't have this. This was just too plain. So what they decided to do was, let's have them combine. Let's do something. They would combine in two ways. The first way is, it's kind of called the Mega Dragonzord, but it's really mainly called Dragonzord Fighting Mode or Battle Mode. What you would do is strip down the Megazord. And I'm gonna go ahead and take off these cannons. I know they appeared on the Megazord later on, but these guys fall off. So I'm just gonna put them aside. Look, see, they're right down here. They're gonna stay. I'm gonna take the head. I'm gonna put it right down here also. Don't worry, it's not going anywhere. So you're gonna strip down the Megazord, take off the Pterodactyl, undo all of this junk, and Tyrannosaurus, you can just lay him down. He's crippled. He's not needed anymore. Now, for the Dragonzord, what you would do, fold his legs down, fold this little tab up, and then fold the leg up until you had this little action. And you may notice, hey, those look kind of familiar. Could that be there for a reason? Yes, it's there for a reason. I don't know why you sound like that, but fold up the legs. I know I didn't really show that, but you're just folding up feet. What's the big deal? Take off the tail. Slide the tip in. That sounds really dirty. And then open up the sides of the arms. Slide in the cannon arms. And then you're just going to open him up. Just open him all the way up. And pull out his middle chest section. Lock those back in place. Slide those forward. Lock them in place. Put him into his feeties. Looks kind of cool. It's not bad looking. And then take the arms and slide them on much as you would the original Megazord. These, I don't think, clamp on in his back at all. So they are solely locked in by his arms. And then flip his mouth down to expose his little face. He's got a little face. Now, he's a little bit taller than the original Megazord. Factor in that's pretty much how tall the original would be. Put him into his little feet. Not bad. We saw this mode occasionally. Yeah, it wasn't a really common thing, but we did see it. He does have a weapon. Take the tail, take the chest piece. They click in place. And then the Dragozord also came with... This little guy falls off quite a bit. The Dragozord also came with these little components. And you would take those down like this. And this little peg would fit in his hand. I'm not going to put it in his hand because it's kind of hard to get to stay. But this would be the power staff to go along with the power sword. Now, the pro with using the Dragozord battle mode is that it was stronger than the original Megazord, but it was a lot slower. So they're kind of risking speed for power, which could work, but still, not so much. Now, there was one other combination. Strip this guy down again. There's a lot of stripping down when it comes to Megazords. Alright, and you are going to make the Megazord again. Oh man, you guys are getting your money's worth in this video, I gotta say. Okay, there's Megazord. You would do this. You would fold back the little side doolollies for his head, pull down the shoulder pads, and then take the Dragozord and fix his face for one. That's scary. Now leave it up. Lock these into his sides. Angle, he looks like he was originally. Open him up completely. Fold down these little clips. And then when you slide them on, the little clips, I'm not sure how well you can really see that, but they fit into his shoulders and just lock him in place. And then you have the Mega Dragozord. Not bad looking. He's stronger than the Dragozord battle mode, but again, he's so top heavy, it made him a lot slower. So it was kind of, let's sacrifice our speed for more power type deal. Looks nice. I mean, it looks pretty cool. But, it's not the best they could do. Let's move him aside. Of course, there's more. They had to bring in a Brachiosaurus named Titanus. Now, I just want to warn you, you may notice that Titanus' tail is kind of mismatched. When I have my Titanus posed, his side is kind of caught next to a bookcase, so I wind up pulling one of the cannons off. And I cannot find the other cannon. It's packed away in a box of accessories somewhere. So I'm going to have to use the Space Titanus tail. They look exactly alike, just one's white and one's gray. Just bear with me, okay? So here we have Titanus. Titanus was brought in to be the final piece in the trio, the triangle of the Ultra Zord. Titanus is also known as the Carrier Zord because he would carry Zords. And I just dropped a sword. Zord, sword, board, board. Board. Board, 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 board. Very nice. Articulation-wise, the neck has a little bit of movement. The head can move up and down. His mouth does open. You gotta force him. Does open about that much. Pretty nice. When he rolls, you may notice his paws kind of move. Now, let me put these guys aside so you can see what all he does. Titanus is, I think, one of the coolest gimmicks we've had in the Zord. Maybe it's one of the coolest. I don't know. But, I'm going to spin around. There's a little switch here. But if you can look at it. It's right here. And it's kind of hard to see, but there's a little switch. When you push that in, Titanus will roll. And when he rolls, his paws move and as if he's walking. So just... I'm going to show his paws moving real quick, and then I'm going to show him rolling. he rolls pretty well. I mean, and then pull the switch out to stop. He rolls a lot faster than, like, you know, Omega Supreme and Skylinks and all those. Has nice speed. It's a nice little gimmick. It's very, it's kind of minor. And it's a feature I wish they had left in for the Space Titanus when he was brought out. But I'll get to that later. To turn Titanus into his carrier mode for the Zords, you will take off his tail. And I'm going to leave these off because they are kind of hard to put on. As I'm doing everything else, I'll save this for later. Take the Dragon Zord tail, and you will mount this inside the back of Titanus. It just kind of rests. It doesn't really lock in place, but it'll rest in there, so it's okay. Open around to his front, pull off his front paws, pull off the front chest piece, grab the inside of this and slide it down, and at the same time, you're going to push down on these front wheels to extend those. All right, he's getting there. Now, this is the Return of Titanus figure. I'll cover more about this later on. But this guy, this is the original Dragon Zord chest piece. It looks nice. It's not bad. It's pretty cool. The Return of Titanus came with its own chest piece. The electronics were stripped out. There were no sticker detailing except for this middle one. You know, just to show how they look together. I'm going to use the original Dragon Zord because this is the original Dragonzord combination. And this just fits in place just like that. Now this piece will fall off quite a bit. It's common, don't worry about it. But it rests. It's a little bit loose, but oh well. Next, you gotta prep the Megazord. Ooh, here we go. Here's the Megazord. Take the chest piece of Titanus, put it on the front. It kind of locks in there. Pull the arms out. And flatten Titanus' paws so they're straight. And we're gonna do it this way. There are little clips right in the middle here. Those are gonna be used to clip this onto the Megazord's hands. So there's that. I actually reversed them so you have this part on top. But looks pretty cool. Adds little thumbs to these guys, which will come into play later on. But there's that. Makes them really top heavy. Next, open up this compartment on Titanus, and the Megazord just rests right inside like this. It doesn't really lock into place, but its feet are in there so well that it does become rather sturdy. Let me tilt this up a teeny bit. Okay. Next, since you have little thumbs, you're going to take the chains of Titanus and put them inside the thumbs, and then close the hands. This will kind of add the whole illusion that the Megazord is kind of controlling Titanus, like, come on, mush, kind of thing. And these guys you do kind of right off the bat, but I save till later because they kind of fall off. They don't really fit as securely, but there's a little hole here. And what you're going to do is you're going to just slide these right onto his body. And they rest like this. These become cannons for Titanus. I'll do it here so I can actually see what I'm doing. And then, there you go. There is the Ultra Zord. Yeah. It's a beast. This is, I think, the best Ultra Zord combination that we've had through all of, you know, the Power Rangers seasons that I've personally watched. Looks very nice. Looks pretty cool. It's you know, it's iconic, if you ask me. These guys are kind of rare to find. They are the original. They are the setup for Power Rangers. But I think it's ultimately worth it. The wheel gimmick does still work. He does still roll. You can even turn this on while they're moving if you want to add that little extra flair to it. There. But if you are a Power Rangers fan, I would highly recommend picking these guys up. They are worth it. They are fantastic. And they're iconic, you know? That's it. I'm going to go. I hope you have a great day. I hope you enjoyed this redo type video. And I will see you around. Take care.